Hello everyone, myself Prithviraj Tambe, working as an assistant professor in Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to learn general purpose I/O port of LPC1768. At the end of this session, student will be able to illustrate the structure of GPIO related memory map registers, and they also configure desired functions of port pins of LPC1768. Outline. Let us understand the ports of LPC1768. So LPC1768 comes with 5 general purpose bidirectional digital IO ports, port 0 to port 4. They supports fast GPIO, that is enhanced or accelerated features. Additionally, port 0 and port 2 pins can be used to generate single interrupt. GPIO ports are generally used for general purpose input output interfacing, driving indicators like LEDs, controlling off-chip devices like relays, or sensing digital inputs. So let us see each port one by one. Port 0, total 20 pins can be used as a GPIO, but you will see that P0.12, 13, 14 and 31 are reserved. They are not available for the user. For port 1, 24 pins are available, and P1.2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 11, 12 and 13 are reserved. Port 2, total 14 pins are available. P2.14 through P2.31 are not available. For port 3, 2 pins are available only, 3.25 and 3.26. Remaining pins are again reserved. Similarly for port 4, again 2 pins are available, 4.28 and 4.29, and the remaining pins are again reserved. Let us calculate the total number of GPIO pins available. So yes, total up to maximum 17 GPIO pins are available for the user. Now these ports can be controlled by 5 groups of memory map registers. They are byte addressable, half word addressable, or word addressable. So fast IO direction control register, fast IO mask register, fast IO set register, fast IO clear register, and fast IO pin value register. So these 5 registers you can use to use GPIO port functionality. So all these GPIO registers are, as I said, byte, half word and word addressable. So byte and half word addressability allows the user easier and faster access to the physical port pins. They are all bit level control registers, means a single instruction controls any number of bits or pins in one port. So let us see general purpose IO port direction control register. So this word accessible fast IO DR register is a 30 bit wide, controls the direction of each pin of port X. So here you will see that fast IO 0 direction control register is rewritable and the memory address is shown here. So total number of registers, direction control registers, are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. All the registers are rewritable and the default values are 0, 0, 0. The meaning is all the GPIO port pins by default set to inputs after reset. So this fast IO direction control register controls the direction of each port pin of port X. Example, fast IO 0 direction control register, bit 0 controls P0.0 and bit 31 controls P0.31. So direction control bit is effective only when that particular pin GPIO function is selected. Again, you have two values, 0 and 1. So 0 means that pin will be configured as an input, and 1 means that pin will be configured as an output. Now let us solve some examples how to set the directions. So let us use fast IO 0 direction control register, which selects the direction of port 0 pins. So we need to follow some steps. So we need to first logical AND the default contents of this register with a mask, which is used to preserve the direction of other port pins which we are not interested, and then logical OR the result with the desired direction value. So let us set the direction of P0.4, which is a port 0 pin, as an input. So here you will see that there are some predefined directions, and we are interested in only P0.4 direction. So this predefined direction is the output, and we need to change it to input. So first ANDed with this mask, then OR with the desired value, we set the direction of P0.4 as an input. So after writing all these combinations in hex, you will get these values. So you can write a statement like fast IO 0 DR register ANDed with 0xFFFFFFEF and OR with the desired value, which is 0 here. You can skip this step. Also keep in mind, refer the standard header file LPC17XX.h for the standard definition of all these registers. Let us configure the P0.5 pin of port 0 as an output. So here again we have a 32-bit pattern, and we are interested in now bit 5, because bit 5 is responsible for setting the direction of P0.5. So here by default, the direction of P0.5 set as input, and we need to change it to the output. So first step is the ANDing with the mask, and the mask is created like this. So 0 value for bit 5 and 1 for the remaining bits. So after ANDing, you will get that the direction of remaining pins are preserved, only the direction of P0.5 is changed, and we are ORing our desired value or desired direction for output, which is 1. So after ORing the desired value, we will get final value. So after writing all these in hex, we will see that FIO0DR register ANDed with 0xFFFFFDF, which you can actually skip, because by only ORing also you can change the direction of port pin as output. So fast IO 0DR register ORed with itself 0x000020. So these statements change the direction of P0.5 as an output. You can skip this masking part, and for writing your C program, again refer a header file LPC17XX.h for the standard definition of all these registers. For further learning, you can read LPC168 datasheet UM10360. Thank you.